A new relation had entered our lives with the development of our vehicles. But then, speed took over our lives. The value of journey was kept aside and the uttermost priority became reaching the destination. To achieve that, we lost the loyalty. The vehicles who could not survive the competition of speed were replaced by the more convenient ones. With time, cars reduced you from being a family member to a rechangeable tire. Yet, there are a few of us who refuse to the speed race and enjoy the journey.
I had seen this particular car in my childhood days as a place to play. This car was really a storage junk. When I was in class, maybe class 3-4, I used to play inside the car. But I knew each and every part of the car. I had another Fiat 1100. So I used to try and match both the cars. And later in the year 1983, when this car was restored, and the feeling to be with a restored car on a vintage car rally was great for me.
আমার ছোটবেলায় মেলা থেকে গাড়ির ইন্টারেস্ট হয় বিকজ আমার দাদামশাই অনেক গাড়ি ছিল মাই ফাদার উনিও খুব হি ওয়াজ ভেরি কিন অ্যাবাউট গাড়ি বাড়িতে অনেকগুলো গাড়ি ছিল এবং এগুলো টাইম টু টাইম বাড়িতেই রিপেয়ারিং সার্ভিসিং এগুলো হতো ছোটবেলায় দাঁড়িয়ে দাঁড়িয়ে কাজ দেখতাম আমার খুব ইন্টারেস্ট পেতাম কাজ দেখে
It's very simple. I think when you're born in a family where your garage is hosting so many cars and you're always talking cars and you're breathing cars and your dad is primarily focusing on vintage and classic cars, then I think it gets inculcated in your system. So that's how that was a natural interest which was, you know, sort of injected into my scheme of things.
And I would say that really, that particular day when I reached the vintage car rally site, the site was perhaps, it started from Statesman somewhere, Statesman House Red Road somewhere, and it ended up in, if I'm not mistaken, in the year 83, it ended up Airport Hotel. So that was a great feeling for me. I have been in the rally site with this particular car since 1983. I was a kid then. There was another Adler, which was also restored and participated in that particular rally, the 1938 one. So that particular day had been really instrumental in my life, in making my thoughts for future, being with this car and being a part of it.
After my student career, I joined service for a few years and my dad was aging, so he gave me an option one fine day that either you join the workshop and take over these cars or else I encash these cars. It's as simple as that.
কিন্তু আমার somehow চাকরি থেকে ইন্টারেস্টটা বেশি গাড়ির উপর ছিল যার জন্য একটা কারখানা গাড়ির করার খুব ইচ্ছে ছিল আর বাড়িতে দুটো পুরনো গাড়ি ছিল মানে ভিনটেজ গাড়ি সেগুলো ফেলা অবস্থায় ছিল বহু বছর ধরে মানে প্রায় অকেজ হয়ে গিয়েছিল জাঙ্ক হয়ে গিয়েছিল কেউ চড়তো না তো সেই গাড়িগুলোর ওপর ফোকাস করে গাড়িগুলোকে বার করে আলটিমেটলি আমি চালু করি একটা ওয়ার্কশপ তৈরি করা হয় ইনিশিয়ালি মডার্ন গাড়ির কাজ করতাম ফুললি কিন্তু পরে আমি দেখলাম যে না মডার্ন গাড়ি খালি কাজ করে কোনো লাভ নেই আর আমার কাছে খুব একটা ইন্টারেস্টিংও লাগলো না যার জন্য আই সুইচ ওভার টু ভিনটেজ
অ্যান্ড বিইং উইথ দ্য কার ফর অল দিজ ইয়ার্স আই হ্যাভ লার্নড ওয়ান থিং আনলেস You can personally monitor and personally oversee the repairing and restoration. Your car is never going to be restored.
It's a very difficult profession to be a part of. You're not getting any labor, you don't get any skilled labor. Modern car mechanics don't want to work on vintage cars because they don't understand vintage cars. There is no concept of replacing things in vintage cars, it's primarily repairing and restoring parts which have gone wrong and other things.
मेंटेनेंस के बारे में है कि पुराना गाड़ी थोड़ा पकड़ के काम करने वाला देख सुन के करने पड़ते हैं, नॉर्मल गाड़ी के काम तो नॉर्मली के तरह होते हैं, आजकल रंग भी टूके पेंट निकले हैं, आई सब सब आईसीआई का डुगो का होते हैं।
जैसा कि हम लोग जैसे दरवाजा का पिन वो बहुत दिक्कत हो जाता है, जैसे मडगार्ड दरवाजा आउट हो जाता है उसे लैन करने में हम लोगों को थोड़ा दिक्कत होता है, टेबल होता है, फिर भी हम लोग करते हैं उसको। जब हाथ का काम होता है तो थोड़ा लाइन करने में आउट होता है, फिर उसको हम लोग उसको जो है लाइन कर लेते हैं। यही हम लोग का एक तो दिक्कत वाला काम है, चार्टो डोर लाइन करना।
अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ स्पेयर पार्ट्स, पुरानो मार्केटे पुरानो गाड़ी जिनिस खुजले आगे पावा जो नतुनो पावा जो सेकेंड हैंडो पावा जो एन मार्केटे और मोटामोटी को माल नहीं, जार जन जा माल दरकार है गाड़ीगुलो तैरि करार्जन मोटामोटी सब ही फैब्रिकेट करते हैं।
But where we have an advantage now is you have the internet and you can import any component which is not available or is defunct, you can import it. So that it costs a lot of money, but it's gettable if you have the money.
The other very important aspect that I've learned is that you do not need always money for restoring a car. Yes, money is necessary. Without money, you certainly cannot restore a car. But to restore a car, you must have the contacts, A. B, you should be in a position to understand what is the defect. The mechanic is there, but the mechanic may not be able to appreciate what is the defect in the car. So it is you who will also be required to assist the mechanic, either with regard to its restoration, and especially for these cars where after the Second World War, the entire company of the car vanished.
The whole vintage car trade is about patience. The entire vintage car if you have one car, if you have 10 cars, if you have 5 cars, it doesn't matter. The whole thing is about patience, because one thing you've got to realize, these are old machines and they'll have numerical hiccups, numerous hiccups, and they'll have several breakdowns, several issues. So you need to know that patience is going to be tested at every single point. So you just got to control your mind over it, and you know things are going to go wrong. You'll have more days when things are not going your way than days where things are falling into place.
हम लोग जो पार्ट नहीं मिलता है उसको चदरा से हम लोग हाथ से बनाते हैं, जैसा कि चक्का का कैप हुआ, इस गाड़ी में दो कैप था और चार कैप मिस था, हमने चार कैप हाथ से बनाया।
हाँ, हम लोग को बहुत सा गाड़ी में या विंटेज कार का जो काम नहीं होता उसको बना के करके रिफाइव करके उसको कंप्लीट करते हैं, ओरिजिनल तरीका से फिर उसको तैयार करते हैं, जो कि पहले का आपका अमरीकन सब काम किया हुआ माल नहीं मिलता उसको बना के करके सब उसको कोशिश करके सब उसको कंप्लीट करते हैं ओरिजिनल, क्योंकि हम लोग का काम में ओरिजिनल नहीं होने से फिर पास नहीं होता है। विंटेज कार में सब ओरिजिनल ही लगता है, सब काम में उसी में सब काम को करते हैं।
यू हैव टू हैंडल योर क्राइसिस, it's not a question of crisis management here. I think even the party concerned knows it's an old product. I know he's paying a lot of money for the restoration, and we're trying to do, he's trying to pay us the best price, we're trying to do him the best job, but in this there can always be a lag. There can be a situation where something goes wrong, because everything is 70 years old, everything is 80 years old, which is reconditioned and put, and everything is a mechanical and an electrical part which can go wrong at any minute. So I think a certain amount of understanding has to be with the client as well, and it always helps. I have been lucky, we have considerate clients, so I have not been pushed to the corner on that regard.
Vintage car will continue to roll despite the difficulties being faced by the owners, and despite the time and the money, people will still feel their love for these cars, and they will continue to roll these cars no matter whatever it takes. Now here you have to understand one very important thing, that people who love these cars would be time spending not only their money but also spending time, and if you can spend time with a particular vintage car, I'm sure the vintage car will roll. It is true that after a particular point of time it will be very difficult, means for certain cars where spares are not at all available, it will be very difficult for the owners to get them restored. But despite that, efforts would be there and the cars would roll at least for one day in a year.